the best words in sports. College basketball is back, and man, what a way to kick off the 2018-2019 season. I'm now joined at the desk by Ennis Warlick to offer his reactions to the opening games of the season. So, Ennis, there were a lot of questions surrounding Kansas being the number one team in the country, but they looked the part, a 91-87 victory over Michigan State. Do you agree with Kansas being the number one team?
I don't, but I do want to start off by saying that Kansas is a very good team. They boast a very sound basketball team. I mean, this is a Kansas Jayhawk team that has a great rim protector in Udoka. Dietrich Lawson, also a great player. But I just don't see them as the number one team. Michigan State's also a great team, too. And this was a great win, but I just don't see them as that number one team.
Gotcha. And we'll talk about Duke's freshman class. They came in as the best in the country. On Tuesday night, they demolished Kentucky by 34 points, number two Kentucky, nevertheless. How big of a statement was this for Duke, and how worried should the rest of college basketball
be? So let me tell you a little bit of a story.
Go ahead. So, I'm ready.
So when I was little, I used to play 2K.
Okay.
And I used to play 2K by myself, and I would plug in, this is before I knew what game sliders were, and I used to plug in another controller and just let it play, just let it have like violations, let it do like the computer do stupid stuff, and then I would just demolish the computer. This was like kind of like that.
Yeah,
it was just a bloodbath. It was awful. Duke is absolutely the number one team in the nation, and they showed that. Kentucky is a very good team, and this is a John Calipari team. I mean, they're going to come out and play, but they didn't. Duke had their way with them. Zion Williamson played great. RJ Barrett played great. Trey Jones played great. I mean, everyone.
Some of these plays just look like a complete cheat code.
Did you see the play Zion Williamson just
the backspin down and then the layup and the dunk.
That was right.
And then Zion doing his thing that we all expected. Duke is certainly someone to like reckon with. So as the college basketball season continues, what are you looking the most forward to seeing?
It's this Duke Blue Devil team. This is coming from a UNC fan. This is far and away the best team in the nation. They're showing it, and they're going to be exciting. This is just a great young basketball team, but they also have a lot of veterans too. Marquise Bolden, Jack White coming off the bench had 7 rebounds. He played great in that game. This is a very good team, and they're going to be exciting to watch.
Do you think there's anyone remotely close to the level that Duke could be playing at by the end of the year?
Kansas. I think Kansas is the second best team in the nation. But other than that, I don't see them beating Duke. I mean, do you?
No, not really.
No, I mean,
as we said, it's a cheat code.
They just beat the second team in the nation by 34 points. That's unheard of. It's absurd. No, I don't see anybody.
So nobody's in their way. This year, do you think? What is stopping Duke from winning a national championship, do you think?
What's stopping them is just maturity, I guess. I guess. I mean, that's just a nitpicky thing. They do have a lot of veterans, but their veterans aren't necessarily their leaders on the court, I guess you would say.
Gotcha.
Zion Williamson and RJ Barrett are really like the focal point of that team. And I didn't even mention Cameron Reddish, who also played. He played great role player minutes as well. But no, I mean, maybe their lack of experience, but I mean, they still do have experience there as well. I would say maybe that, but I. Yeah.
Well, as Duke makes a tear, that's all the time we have for college basketball. When we come back, Matt and I will be discussing the best jersey customizations. Stay tuned.